Hello, what's up? Welcome to another quick edit video. This time I'm working on probably the best sunset image from the last year. And the main problem I'm fixing here is the underexposure which is going on in the foreground. Also, I'm applying a lot of glow and overall change up the colors a little bit to give this image a warmer look. So let's start with the editing. As usual, I'm in the Camera RAW editor to do the basic RAW adjustments, and I'm starting in the Optics tab by activating those settings. Next, I'm switching the camera profile to Adobe Landscape, which will give me more saturation but also will help to restore some detail in the darker areas, as you can see. Now let's work on a warmer look. For this, I can simply change the white balance to cloudy, and you can see this will make the sky a lot warmer. Then, to save some of the details in the foreground, the first thing I want to try is to simply bring up the exposure. This does help, but of course I will get a lot of overexposure in this area, which is a problem. So let's try to fix that by bringing down the highlights. Okay, that actually works pretty good. I will fix the sky later using local adjustments, but for now let's work on the foreground. I think I can pull up the shadows a bit to get back some more detail. Alright, I think I could use some more sharpness in here, so I'm increasing the texture. I'm doing this very, very careful since the texture slider is super powerful. Also, I'm adding some clarity. And to get some contrast, I'm also using the dehaze. Alright, I could boost the vibrance some more for more saturation. One thing I'm usually doing here is to drop the saturation slider, since in my opinion this will just look better. Okay, let's take a closer look at the local adjustments, and I want to start with the gradiated filters. Here I first want to work on the sky and get back some more details of those amazing clouds. The first thing I could do is to simply increase the contrast. As you can see, this helps already, but let's also add some clarity. I just don't want to overdo it, since I would lose some saturation here. Now I want to make the blue part of the sky a little darker, so I could drop the blacks. And I think I could also drop the overall exposure. Alright, that makes the sky a lot more dramatic. Now let's work on the foreground. I'm using this gradiated filter to make the very near foreground just a little bit darker, so let's drop the exposure. You can see this works just like some kind of vignetting effect. Also, I'm dropping the whites here altogether. And to prevent underexposure, I'm increasing the blacks slightly. Okay, I could maybe also add some clarity, but that should be it. Then I have another gradiated filter for the foreground. And this one is just to add some more texture and some clarity to the foreground. And you can see, this will bring out a lot more detail in this field. Alright, that should be it for the gradiated filters. Then let's take a look at the radial filters. And with those two, I want to add some glow in this area. And as usual, I'm just increasing the blacks first. Here I can make this effect stronger by dropping the dehaze. I just need to be careful. Now I guess there will be overexposure in this area, but I think in this case it will look pretty cool, so I don't care if there's detail lost. However, I do want to add some more warmth in this area, so let's increase the temperature. Alright, nice. And for the smaller radial filter, I'm basically doing the same thing. Increase the blacks, increase the temperature, and let's also drop the dehaze. Alright, nice. And that's it for the local adjustments already. Then comes the color grading, and I'm starting this in the Tone Curve tab. In the red channel, I'm simply picking the right point and carefully drag it to the left. This will introduce some more red tones to the highlights and just help to improve those sunset colors. Okay, then for the color mixer, in the luminance tab, I can make the blue part of the sky a little darker and thus giving the image some more contrast by bringing down the blue luminance. Okay, then let's switch to the saturation and boost the orange tones. And I want to drop the green tones, since the field in the foreground is a little too saturated in my opinion. Alright, that looks pretty nice. Then of course I'm also applying some split toning. And for the highlights and the midtones, I want to have a warm color tone, which fits the sunset. Somewhere in this range maybe, but let's drop the saturation. Alright. And again, do the same thing for the midtones. Somewhere in this range maybe. But here I want to have a rather low saturation. Alright. And for the shadows, I'm going for a colder look. Somewhere in this range, again with a low saturation. Nice. The final color grading happens in the calibration tab. Here I'm just dropping the blue primary hue, which will give the sky some intenser red tones. And of course, we could also boost the saturation a bit. Alright. Nice. I think I also want to add some vignetting. Just a little bit, not too much. That looks pretty good. And finally, in the details tab, I'm going to sharpen the image. And that's it for the raw adjustments. So let's open it up in Photoshop. First, of course, I'm using the spot healing brush to get rid of the sensor spot right there. Then let's apply a new layer, and with this one I want to enhance the glow effect on the right side a little more. For this layer I'm setting the blending mode to soft light. Then I'm grabbing the brush by pressing B, and by holding down the Alt key and clicking in this area I can pick up this color tone. Let's drop the brush opacity first. And now I'm carefully painting in some more glow here. Alright, that should be enough. Then I'm merging those two layers, and I really have to hold myself back to not overdo the editing here, but there's one more thing I want to apply, and that's coming from the Nick Collection plugin. And here, let's head for the Glamour Glow effect, just to give this image some nice glow. I do want to restore some of the saturation and drop the glow strength. Maybe even introduce some more warmth. But that should be enough. So let's apply it like this. And here we have the finished image. So I hope this was interesting and helpful. As always, if you have questions about editing, feel free to ask in the comments. And thank you so much for watching this video.